Hello everybody, my name's Tank Runner, and welcome to another episode of Drawing Roulettes and World Building, where we randomly combine prompts that you guys send me, I draw them, and then we try and build a setting or a world that all these concepts can exist in. Quick sidebar, what do you guys think I should call this series? Drawing Roulettes and World Building gets all the information across, but it's not really winning any awards for style. Needs a bit more flavor. Here are the words you sent me to fit our Frozen Terror setting, and here are their random combinations. Today we're going to be finishing up this setting, which we've called the Frozen Wastes. If you haven't seen the first episode, that's fine, but feel free to check it out. It's got the first four of these drawing prompts. Link to that in the description. That's enough of an explanation of what's going on here. We got a lot of stuff to do, so let's get started. All right, prompt one, numb and scrumptious. This was a weird one, but I think I brought it around to the aesthetic we're looking for. It took some effort, but somehow I got scrumptious to a terrifying place. Like I told you guys last time, I've been using these prompts as an opportunity to play with shadow a bit more than what I'm used to. Scholars say a long time ago, during the Age of the Gods, towards the end of the Second Era, the Frozen Wastes were struck with a powerful earthquake that sent fissures across the tundra. And of course, because of the lack of proper education here, many of our denizens can't wait to throw their lives away to investigate what treasures or hidden knowledge must await them at the deepest points of these chasms. But I must say, one aspect of these fissures has always piqued my interest, something the locals have come to call Scarlet Caverns. Scarlet Caverns are very easy to spot if you know what you're looking for, but they can blend in with their environment well enough to trick most travelers at first glance. Most of the time, you won't realize you're in one until it's too late. I hesitate to call them sentient, but there is some kind of intelligence behind them, something otherworldly, a possession, more like. The farther down you go, the harder it is to keep your mind steady. You'll see things, hear things, you begin to lose yourself. Or more aptly, the cavern strips you of all things and shows you a truer version of yourself that you might not be ready to see. I've sent many experienced spelunkers after these entities, and only one has ever returned. She burst into my office with one less extremity than the last time I had spoken to her, and told gruesome stories of how the cave had devoured the rest of her team, and that it had gotten a taste of her, and wouldn't leave her alone until it got more. She made me promise not to send another soul into the Scarlet Cavern. But I'm not about to give up on my life's work just to keep a promise with some lunatic that probably just left her people down there to die. I'll be sending another team next month, but this time, I'll be accompanying them. You know what they say. If you want something done right. Angel and Derecho. I was excited to finally get to this prompt because I was interested in seeing how I would do drawing lightning. Everyone has drawn the basic static lightning scribbles or the stereotypical lightning bolt symbol, but this was my first attempt to take the time to work with color and style. I also don't really get many chances to draw celestial creatures, so this was a fun one for me. A strange anomaly has been appearing across the Frozen Wastes. Smaller, more manageable storms have been colliding and causing unspeakable destruction at their point of contact. Do not misunderstand me. Storms will sometimes combine, creating a new storm and continuing on their expected course, but this is different. During this phenomena, the storms do not swirl together. They seem to push against each other. They lock in place and concentrate their destruction on one particular spot. It's nothing like we've seen before. Approaching these storms can be extremely dangerous, depending on multiple variables. At the location of impact, we've seen villages buried under mountains of snow, winds strong enough to send wooden or even stone structures flying through the air, lightning so powerful that it leaves massive craters in the earth. Needless to say, if you are standing where this natural disaster is created, your time left on Ethos is limited. Me and a few others were recently sent to follow these storm patterns in an attempt to learn if it would be possible to harness this energy. However, the study was cut short due to losing half of our team out in the field. As far as I know, the fools aren't dead yet, they just chose to leave. They spoke of voices in the storm. Powerful shouting echoing down from the heavens, they said. One of them even claimed that for a moment, when lightning struck, they saw figures. Shadows cast down when the clouds lit up in the sky. I saw no such thing. It's good riddance, if you ask me. We have no room for fairy tales when dealing with such matters. Let them do what they wish. If they want to freeze to death on some mountain peak, attempting to speak with men in the sky, so be it. Prompt 3, Goat and Shadow. Originally, I was going to do Saint and Avalanche and try and tie it to the previous prompt, but I eventually decided against it and went for something completely different. It didn't take long for me to settle on this drawing being of a creature silhouette instead of the creature itself. Yet another thing that I don't do a lot of that this video series has allowed me to try. This one took the most time of all 8 of the prompts I did for the Frozen Wastes. Normally, these drawings take anywhere from 1 to 3 hours, but this one was more like 8, I think. I don't think the finished artwork looks like I put that much time into it, so I suppose that means I kind of dropped the ball on this one. I was just having a really hard time making the creature look as if it was in the distance, and was only being lit from behind by moonlight without making the overall drawing too dark or too bright. The Kratar. I find myself in a small settlement called Lynchwood. I'm here because I recently overheard an old wives' tale about a creature that has been terrorizing the locals as of late, that I believe fits the description of a Kratar. I've asked around the oldest citizens of Lynchwood, and those who weren't too stubborn to speak with an outsider told stories of adventuring parties getting turned around in the woods due to snowstorms and being hunted by a creature that they refer to as Luda Dynem, translated roughly to the Game Master. This creature seems to control the bad weather, as it's always accompanied by it. The Luda Dynem stays out of sight and slinks around in the shadows, allowing its victim only proof of its existence. Glowing eyes through the trees, its silhouette cast by moonlight from a hilltop. The story goes that the creature wants nothing but to find amusement from your pain, and will force travelers to take part in a series of tasks and challenges to win their freedom from the storm. No one I spoke to had ever seen this creature or took part in one of its games, but their second-hand retellings of the Luda Dynem's games leaves little to the imagination, and I'd rather not repeat them here. There can be only one survivor of these games, and the winner is seldom referred to as lucky. Those who make it home are torn apart by guilt, and many of them take their own lives. Others who came home and drunkenly boasted in the local tavern of their victory over the creature and their lost allies were eventually hunted by the Luda Dynem again. I have no doubts that this is the work of a Kratar. However, chances are, due to how far back these stories go, these people have not experienced one Kratar, but several. Regardless, I'll deal with the Kratar and bring its body back to the settlement. But it's probably for the best that I let them continue to believe that this is just a monster specific to this area. They're not very likely to pay me for the kill if they know that another one is most likely to show up in just a few years. Slay and Thawed. Not gonna lie, I kinda cheated on this one. I was prepping for a new D&D campaign last week and drew this rough sketch as a concept I was working on, but then when I started doing these videos, this random prompt came up and it fit the idea too perfectly not to use it. So this drawing was done before I started this prompt, but I decided that I was going to add some more bells and whistles to it, give the artwork a bit more style, something to make the drawing work really well with the world building. Over the last 3 years, I've been working with a small settlement off the north coast to build a roadway that travels across the frozen wastes. If successful, the time and effort needed to travel from one side of Ethos to the other will be cut in half. Obviously, the wastes are far too dangerous to place down a cobble road and call it a day, so I've been drawing up plans for a form of transportation that will not only protect any valuables or passengers on board, but can easily traverse difficult terrain that might arise between destinations. It took me quite some time, but during last year's winter, I finally perfected my design, and I've just been waiting for the day where the scavengers find something that we can use to power such a machine. And today is that day. An ancient construct. I've been calling it Rhaegar. It was built to dig away at bedrock, and it's powered exclusively by arcane runes and good old-fashioned coal furnaces. It runs much hotter than expected, but it's nothing I can't account for during construction of the harness. If done correctly, Rhaegar will be capable of towing my machine from the inside and melting any large quantities of snow or ice that he may encounter. The cost of chartering vessels to deliver shipments to foreign lands is already unreasonable. But imagine if I charge the same price, but guaranteed a faster delivery, no lost shipments, and zero casualties to their hired guards. Suddenly, not so unreasonable, is it? Well, that's going to do it for this episode of our video series where we world build and draw some terrifying creatures. Please like, share, and subscribe. It really helps us out. If you have some ideas for settings we should do in the future, or maybe you already have a whole list of prompts you'd like to see me do, go ahead and leave them in a comment below. If you want to take a crack at drawing any of the prompts I did or any of the ones I skipped over, please let me know. I'm in the middle of getting my Twitter up and running, and I'd love to see what you guys make. But until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.